Good day from Chem Help ASAP. If you have been watching the videos on this channel in their recommended order, then you have seen and used plenty of alkoxides in reactions. We haven't, however, discussed how to make them. Let's do that now. If you go into lab, you are far more likely to find bottles of alcohols like methanol or ethanol than alkoxides, sodium methoxide, sodium methoxide. So when a procedure calls for an alkoxide, how do you get it? Well, normally you make it. There are two main ways to make alkoxides, and both are on the screen. Number one, you can treat an alcohol with sodium hydride, which is a powder that you add to the alcohol. Sodium hydride is a source of hydride, H-. This is a very strong base that deprotonates the alcohol, forms H2 gas, which bubbles away, and leaves the sodium salt of the alkoxide. The second method is reacting the alcohol with sodium metal. Sodium metal is, this represents sodium in its zero oxidation state, or metallic sodium. Sodium metal reacts with the alcohol to form a half equivalent of H2 gas, which bubbles away and gives the alkoxide. These both work well. Although they look similar, they are very different. The sodium hydride methyl involves an acid-base reaction. The sodium metal method is properly a redox reaction. Are there other ways to make alkoxides? Of course, but these two methods are the most common ways to prepare alkoxides in the lab from common alcohols.